Hi, I'm Vanessa Bell Calloway. You may know me as an actress from film, stage, and television, but did you know that I'm a breast cancer survivor and the voice of Know Your Girls, the National Breast Cancer Campaign from the Ad Council and Susan G. Komen. This powerful campaign was created for Black women to help us better understand our risk of breast cancer. And along with Susan G. Komen, I'd like to welcome you into my company of friends. Today, we're going to talk to some experts and chop it up on how to take control of our health. Come on in. I want to welcome everybody back to In the Company of Friends, along with the Susan G. Komen Foundation. We're so happy you're here. And I have this beautiful, you're so pretty.
Thank you.
Breast cancer surgeon is so beautiful.
Thank you. Yes. Listen, you're gorgeous too as a survivor.
Dr. Robita Smith, welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining me today.
Thank you.
I have so many questions I want to ask you, but first I want to ask you, why breast cancer surgery? What led you there?
So my first career, I'm a medical illustrator. So I actually have a degree in drawing the anatomy and drawing
wow.
the surgery and drawing the things that doctors look at when they're learning how to operate or the body or anatomy. And that training took me to going into the operating room as an artist to sketch surgery. I didn't have any doctors in my family. I didn't know anything about medicine and I had already graduated college. So I confided in an orthopedic surgeon who also knew a plastic surgeon who was a medical illustrator at University of Pennsylvania. And I met with him, showed him my artwork, and I said, I want to be a doctor. And he said, you should be a plastic surgeon. I said, great. Went to medical school.
Doctors.
And so I had a chance to shadow a female plastic surgeon,
mm-hmm.
a female breast cancer surgeon.
Okay.
What the breast surgeon did and her compassion and her interaction with her patients was more appealing to me. I basically looked at her and said, I want to be you when I grow up.
Breast cancer is the most common cancer among Black women. We are more likely to be diagnosed younger, at later stages, and with more aggressive forms of the disease, which limits our treatment options. I understand that you know a lot about metastatic breast cancer. Because, you know, I'm going to tell you, these commercials have been coming on, and I'm a 10-year breast cancer survivor.
Congratulations.
So all of a sudden, thank you. Something to be congratulated
yes,
for.
Yes.
And I started seeing all these commercials, and I was like, metastatic breast cancer? They're like living with metastatic breast cancer longer, and they have all these medicines and stuff. And I was like, what is that? I'm sure that I may have heard about it when I was in my journey and didn't pay attention.
Sure.
But it seems like I'm hearing about it more and more and more on television. Why is that?
To understand metastatic breast cancer, you have to understand there are essentially five stages of breast cancer. Stage zero is, I believe, what you have exactly, which
yes.
is there are cancer cells, but they're contained inside the milk duct or lobule of the breast, so they don't spread, so it's not invasive. Once you get into invasive cancer, you have stage one through four. We consider early stage breast cancer stage one and two when it's relatively small. Even usually no lymph nodes are involved, but even if there are, they're a limited number, but there's no spread beyond that. Stage three is what we consider locally advanced, meaning there's a lot of cancer in the breast or a lot of cancer in the lymph nodes, or it has impacted the area, for example, like the skin's involved
mm-hmm.
or the nipples involved or something like that. So it's locally advanced, still not quite yet spread to other parts of the body. Stage four is when it's in the breast, lymph nodes, and other parts of the body. So you're talking about a particular stage where cancer is no longer just contained within the breast and the lymph nodes. I used to tell my patients all the time, we can deal with it being in the breast and the lymph nodes. It's when it has gone someplace else and set up shop that it becomes difficult sometimes to cure and or contain. So years ago, if we said you had stage four or metastatic breast cancer, there wasn't much we can do, depending on how much cancer had already taken up shop other places.
Mm-hmm.
So we really didn't see a lot of women surviving when they had advanced.
So stage four used to be like a death sentence.
Essentially.
Mm-hmm.
But now, with better treatment, we are seeing women who have cancer in other places live longer because we're able to attack it. We can't cure it. We can't make it go away. But we can attack it and contain it and sometimes make it go to sleep, remission, keep it from further spreading and causing symptoms and other damage. And what happens is the more we can do that, the longer a woman can live, sometimes symptom or pain-free or symptom-free for longer periods of time. So now what we're seeing are a lot of women who have metastatic stage 4 cancer are now living longer, active, There's discussions about it. People are talking about it. So now it's become, it's nothing new.
I see. Basically what you're saying is just another name for stage four breast cancer.
Right. Yeah, exactly.
Right.
So
it's, okay.
So metastatic is stage four.
Mm-hmm.
But now that more women, we have women, up to 34% of women with stage four or metastatic breast cancer are living longer, even past 5 years, up to 10 years or more. We never saw that years ago. So it's becoming more of a topic of discussion because there's an awareness saying exactly that.
And are they living longer because of the medicines?
Yes.
Or new technologies, techniques, surgeries?
So a little bit of all of those things. Mm-hmm. Usually what happens is if it's in the breast and we find that we're working up a woman who has even aggressive tumor or a certain size or a lymph node involvement, we start looking to see if it's someplace else. So mm-hmm. part of the diagnosis of not just the biopsy in the breast and the biopsy in the lymph nodes is to do imaging studies of the body, the bones, looking at the brain, looking at the liver, things like that. You want to see, has it gone someplace else? And that's usually when you can help pretty much clinch the diagnosis, whether if this is stage 2, 3, or metastatic. So what we have to do is send medicine all throughout the body to target the area where the cancer has set up shop, or if we're unable to find a location, but we see, for example, we can test women's blood for certain biopsies where we see circulating cancer cells or tumor cells, or we see circulating cells that tells us that there's a lot of cancer cells in the blood and it's more than what's in the breast.
So that means they're on the move. They're circulating.
Exactly.
Like they're on the move.
So that allows us to say, where should our focus be? And for sometimes, depending on how much cancer is in the body, we'll have to say, we're not gonna do surgery in the breast right now. However,
and that's not putting the patient in harm's.
But think about it. So if cancer's in the breast,
uh-huh.
and it's someplace else, the medicine that I'm giving that's attacking
should help both areas.
Exactly.
The campaign is called Know Your Girls because it can be life-saving to know your girls, your breast, as intimately and as deeply as you know the girls in your life. The women who love you, who support you, celebrate you, the women who hold you up through it all, your moms, aunties, your sisters, your best friends, your sorors, and your daughters. Now, if the cancer recurs, mm-hmm. so, because, you know, we know this happens a lot, you know, you may have a mastectomy in one breast, and then years later it comes back. Is it often stage 1, 2, 3, 4? What when it recurs, what do you see the rate of it, you know, where does it recur? At what stage does it recur?
If you've had all the treatment and you have cancer come back, the risk can be anywhere from a 20% chance to a 30% chance or higher, depending on the aggressive biology of the cancer, depending on what you had, like a lumpectomy versus a mastectomy. We do our best to take as much of the fat tissue from the breast that we believe belongs with breast, but we have leave a little bit of fat with the skin or the skin will die.
Mm-hmm.
So even after a mastectomy, a woman with invasive cancer has a risk of cancer coming back in the skin,
oh.
along the incision, but that risk is relatively low. So like 2-3% chance, very, very, very low. However, if you've had a lumpectomy, meaning portion of the breast is
right.
removed, even if your margins are clear and you have radiation, radiation is used to help decrease the risk of cancer coming back in that same spot, as well as the rest of the breast tissue. So if you just remove—
Does it decrease the chance of it metastasizing to some other area, or—
Well—
Will it stop it from playing leapfrog, so to speak?
Well, no, what happens is, if it comes back, mm-hmm. you have a risk of it spreading at that point in time.
Mm-hmm.
And it depends on the biology and aggressiveness of the cancer. For example, if it's a really aggressive cancer the first time you removed it, you had the treatment, for example, triple negative cancer is very aggressive. If you do that and you remove it, it has a 30% chance of coming back.
Ooh, that's kind of high.
Because it's an aggressive kind.
Oh.
So some cancers, yes, when it comes back, there's a risk it could be someplace else. And again, we get very aggressive and we do work up and scan to look for that.
Thank you, Dr. Robina Smith. We're
Thank
so
you.
Happy you're here.
Thank and you for
once
inviting
again,
me.
I'm glad you're my company of friends, and Susan G. Komen, we're glad that you're here.